Kuzambo and welcome to Dawai Kudroen. My guest tonight is Honorable Minister for Agriculture and Forest, Dr. Pema Gyamtsho. Thank you so much for your time, Limbo. I know that you're not feeling well. At the same time, you have a very busy schedule. Despite that, you agreed to come here for the show. Thank you so much for that. Lots of talks going on and lots of gossips, in fact, about the pedestrian day. So because of that, we'd like to have Limbo here and get all these things clarified. First question, as asked in Zonka, I'd like to ask you the same question. Why this pedestrian day on Tuesday? Because many felt that this could be a politically motivated decision for the government when you are nearing the elections. But on the contrary, there are also people who feel that government is taking all these unpopular decisions. Why at this time? Because you are nearing the elections. So.
Thank you very much for inviting me and to talk on this very important subject of the pedestrian day. Now I would like to go straight to your question. I think, as you said, some people think that this is politically motivated. I would like to say that nothing would be far from the truth. I think politically this would be suicidal for any government, any political party to take such a decision just as the election is approaching. So it is politically not good, politically not expedient on the part of the government, on the part of our ruling party to actually get into such a, take such a decision. But we have to take this decision because we thought that it may be too late otherwise. Considering the urgency, considering the increasing natural disasters that we are facing, and right in front of our eyes, we see why it is happening and how much we are contributing to the climate change, to global warming ourselves. And unlike what people think, most of what we experience here in terms of unseasonal rainfall patterns, drought or natural calamities are caused by ourselves. And I think we can do a lot to reduce that. And that is the reason why, we have taken this decision, unpopular as it may seem, because we knew that it would be unpopular. We knew that it would cause short-term inconveniences for individuals and for certain groups. But then we thought that people would understand because this is taken in the, larger interest of the nation, interest of everybody.
So, Your Excellency, now the community or the people who claim to be mostly affected by this decision are the business communities. That in any town or city that you talk about, business communities are the ones who are actually complaining a lot. Because many say that because of this decision, government actually is, in fact, literally stalling the economic development or economic growth in our country. If you were to refute to this,
yes, to a certain extent, yes. I think there would be some businesses affected in the short term, as I said, by this move. But there would be also other businesses which would be, gaining from this, pedestrian day. So there would be winners and there would be losers. And change is never comfortable. Change always brings some degree of discomfort, some degree of pain among, different individuals, different interest groups. But then we have to look at the larger picture. Now, yes, individually I would agree that there may be some businesses suffering, in the short term, especially on Tuesdays. Probably it's true that they would be having less customers. But I wouldn't think that if they look at their balance sheet at the end of the month, there won't be a big difference because at the end of the day, the consumption patterns have not changed. The number of consumers, the consumer population have not changed. So if I need to buy something, I don't necessarily need to buy between 8 and 6 on Tuesdays. I can buy after 6 or I can buy the following day. So I don't think that would be true. But, the businesses like the fuel depot, of course, the petrol sales have gone down, diesel sales have gone down, and that was intended. We would like to reduce the cost of fuel, the imports particularly. And this is also because it's going to help us address the rupee problem, shortage problem. And from our, the responses we got from the petrol stations, already, in a month, we are saving about nearly 3 million meters in Thimphu alone. Now, if you calculate across the country, that would be quite substantial. And annually we are importing 89 million liters of diesel, you know, as compared to about 39 some years ago, 10 years ago.
Yes.
Now that is translating into more than 3.5 billion rupees,
yes,
worth of import. And petrol about 24 million liters a year. And again another 2.5 billion rupees. So I think if we can cut down on fuel import, which we don't produce ourselves, I think we would be, you know, addressing the larger interests of the country, of the, you know, the common people. Now, yes, inconveniences when we have decisions like this, there would be inconveniences. Now, you know, look at the sacrifices our farmers are making, you know, in the name of environment, in the name of conservation,
yes,
in order to protect species from going extinct. Species like tiger, you know, which individually the farmers don't gain, actually they lose a lot, but they're making the sacrifices. They're out there in the field every night guarding their crops. They're making so much sacrifices, and when we here in the urban areas, in the cities, when we have to, you know, walk for just, you know, how many hours is it? Now, we are not walking hours and hours. Actually, we are working about, at the most, maybe 1 hour. And most people walk more, not more than 15, 20 minutes.
Yes.
And if you can't make that much sacrifice and avoid driving for about 2-3 kilometers or half an hour in a day, I don't think that is asking too much from our people.
Yes. Your Excellency, you have been talking about the social benefits. You have been talking about the economic and environmental benefits by having this day as Pedestrian Day. But when, after having declared this day as a Pedestrian Day, there are so many exemptions made. Now you talk about taxis, you talk about the vehicles that are driven by the international agencies, and you talk about the emergency services. Of course, one cannot do away with this emergency services, but some exemptions, like for instance, you have exemptions made for travel agents. So when you have too many exemptions made, some tend to believe that it's not actually a Pedestrian Day. And as rumors have it, some people were nearly hit by cars because the traffic is quite open and people are actually zooming their cars. So this is one of the questions that I've been asked to ask Your Excellency during the break. I got a call from
individuals. This is a very important question, and we also acknowledge that this sort of inconvenience must have happened or must have been caused. And that is because we are just introducing the system.
Yes.
And for us to get used to a new system, I think there are difficulties. Now our police, they're doing an excellent job, but you know, no matter how many policemen we have on the street, how many police women we have on the street, it's not going to help unless we ourselves are committed to it. We are ourselves are convinced that this is something good for us and that we should come forward and help, you know, make this a success. Unless we have that kind of attitude, it's not going to help. Now we have considered all the emergency services like ambulances, and also one reason why we considered the taxis is also because, as I said in the Zonghua, in my Zonghua interview, I also would like to mention that just now we do not have adequate public transport system. So while we are building that up, we would like, you know, we would like to avoid people, you know, from suffering undue inconveniences. So that is why the taxis are allowed. That is one of the reasons. The other reason, of course, is the taxis, the main source of income for the taxi operators are from driving taxis, you know. And if we don't allow that, then not only them, their whole families would lose their source of livelihood. So that is one consideration. But having said that, we have also authorized the RST and the Royal Bhutan Police to actually use their discretion to allow, you know, people with emergency situations to use their own cars. That is why perhaps some of the private cars that people notice, maybe those carrying very sick old people to the hospitals, you know, which we have asked the police to, and also people having to attend to emergencies like going to Tutu and so on. Now, as far as the other emergency services are concerned, well, the B-Mobile and T-Cell and all also came forward, and also the Bhutan Power Corporation. So they also wanted exemption, but we said that as and when their services are required, they could simply call the officer in charge of the Royal Bhutan Police, the traffic sector in charge, and then they will use their discretion and they will be issued that permit to move around. And same goes for any other emergencies. So we have not made any exemption particularly for any group. Now for the tourists, Of course, because the the arrival of the planes and so on, we have to also make concessions for the timing of the flight arrivals. Then, and some of the tourists, they travel for hours and hours, and when they come here, if they do not have access to go to their hotels directly, this would be very harmful to our tourists. But how many tourists are coming in? On Tuesday, very minimal, very few. So it's very negligible. Now, if you look at the other transport services, I think that the international agencies, now the committee has also discussed that, and we said we will leave it up to the international community, especially the heads of the missions, to use their own discretion, to take responsibility, take moral responsibility, and to be able to, cooperate with this. We would like to ask them to cooperate, because this is something that is, not done by Bhutanese for Bhutanese alone. And this is actually a scheme. The climate change issue is something that is a global concern.
Yes.
And I think our international agencies here in Thimphu, we are getting their cooperation, and we hope that they will continue to cooperate and refrain from using cars unless there is an emergency.
Yes. Your Excellency, have you heard of any reports that some of the taxi drivers are actually taking advantage of the situation and taking opportunity to encash or get maximum benefit out of it by doing some unlawful things as well? Some used to have dual number registration number plates, and I've been told that around 8 of them were caught in fact changing the number plates. Because you have that alternatives given to the cab drivers as well. So reports like this does not sound really well.
Yes, we got those reports, and also we discussed how to deal with these kind of situations.
Yes.
And we have given very now strict instructions to the RSTA and the Royal Bhutan Police that if the taxi drivers were caught engaged in such practices, then their licenses would be seized. They will not be allowed to drive taxis at all. In fact, that would deprive them of, having the license to operate their taxis. So I would like to again insist that they should not engage in, first of all, raising taxi fares, engage in, changing number plates like that, or speeding, any of these, malpractices that we have heard. Now, if they are caught, then, it would basically ruin their source of livelihood. So they have to be very careful, and I hope they are listening.
Yes. Yes. Your Excellency, now in the last Meet the Press, we have been told that some sort of study has been conducted by National Environment Commission on this pedestrian day. So if you could share that to all our viewers.
Yes. While it may be still too early to be, to come up with very conclusive results on the impact of this pedestrian day, then we would like to have some indications of the level of support that the general public have for this. So the NEC has engaged some independent enumerators.
Yes.
With a set of questions, and they have interviewed about 500 persons, 500 people on the street randomly. And out of that, about 316 or more than 60% actually said that they support the pedestrian day. And only about 19%, about 94 precisely, said that they do not support, and the rest 90 they had no opinion either way. So on the whole, I think there is a lot of support for this pedestrian day, and I think there is a lot of awareness about the need to keep ourselves healthy, to reduce pollution, to reduce congestion. So all these objectives that we have been aiming for, I think there is a level of awareness among the general public.
Yes. Your Excellency, now let me provoke you by asking this. It's almost a repetition, but I just couldn't resist asking this question. Now, some people, some educated people actually feel that this deputy government led by Honorable Lynchin is trying to gain so much of international popularity and trying to ignore the disadvantages or the problems that we have in hand here in our country, seeking popularity outside. What do you say, sir?
Well, that is again, subject to people's, interpretations and also perceptions, and also their, political stand, I guess. But on the whole, if there is anyone who says that climate change is not happening, that Thimphu is not warmer today than yes, you know, than 10 years ago or several years ago, then I would agree with them that this government is doing only for, you know, the sake of, you know, gaining international popularity. But this is not the case. You know, what we do here have consequences for ourselves. You know, if you don't do anything, I think the negative consequences are there for us to see. Of course, we don't feel it individually. That is why people think that it is only harmful and not beneficial. Because as I said, the benefits are of a long-term nature, and benefits spread across the country, across, you know, cross sections of people, whereas the inconveniences or discomfort, if you like, are restricted to individuals or groups. So that is why I think there's this difference in opinion. But now if you say, you know, what is happening in the country, I would say that, you know, if you look at the number of vehicles, I think you don't have to have statistics, you know, or you don't have to conduct a survey to say that we are overcrowded. You know, from between 2009 and, you know, 2012, the car numbers have now increased from about 36,000 to right now, I think, about 66,000 cars. And then the import of diesel, for example, has reached 89 million liters a year.
Yes.
You know, value about 3.5 billion rupees. And diesel about 24 million liters. Now, these are things that if you don't deal with it now, it will be too late. You know, our environment would be totally polluted. Our streets, we will have more cars than what our streets could carry. You know, the length of the roads that we have, very limited. This parking space is very limited. And we'll reach a stage where it would be very difficult to take any decisions to reverse this trend. So I think this is the time for us to make a difference. You know, it's a small step. No, we are not asking. Actually, this is a very small sacrifice on the part of everybody. You know, we are not doing anything that would ruin anybody's livelihood or career or profession or whatever. Just simply asking our people to take responsibility. And this is something that we should all, you know, participate, because it's not for anybody. This move is not intended to harm anybody, to ruin anybody's business. But this move is also not intended to benefit any particular group or any individual. So it is for our whole country, for everybody in the country.
Yes, Your Excellency, now let me repeat this question. The ones who are mostly affected are the business community, and some big business firms have actually complained, saying that they have never been consulted. Some sort of consultations should be had with them, since they are the ones who are largely affected by this decision. Would you agree, sir?
Yes, could be true, but at the moment, I think we did not get any, you know, petitions, formal petitions or formal complaints as such, with facts and figures, because all these complaints will have to be substantiated with facts and figures. So unless they come with their balance sheets that this has affected their business to such extent that they cannot carry on any longer, you know, complaints would always be there. But I do agree that, you know, some business could have been affected. For example, the car sales, I would imagine, because of the rupee crunch and other factors, the sales may have gone down, and maybe the transport sector, you know, particularly the trucks engaged in carrying, you know, raw materials, they may have been affected because they were not able to adjust to the timing, adjust, you know, plan their, you know, trips properly or so on. So there could be. But on the other hand, if you look at, you know, business like the bicycle shops, they may have gone up. The shoe sales, you know, particularly sneakers, trekking shoes may have gone up. And I would imagine, you know, this kind of businesses would pick up. You know, even soft drinks and, you know, water, all this may pick up because of people now taking up walking and trekking habits and so on. So there would be pluses and minuses, you know, as a result of this move. But as I said, you know, the common the understanding that one should have is to look at the overall balance sheet. Now, with the savings that we can get from, you know, sort of reducing the fuel consumption, from our preliminary calculations that we have, we are saving about 3 million rupees in a month. Rupees, I use rupees because we are importing this. We are not producing fuel in Thimphu alone. Now, that is just among the few depots that we have collected. Now, that is quite substantial. Now, with this money, we can invest in developing our public transport. We can invest in, you know, establishing a school in one of the rural areas, you know, operating some of the the facilities, institutions that do not have adequate resources at this stage. So there are lot of opportunities that have been created by this pedestrian day.
So the fact of the matter is, Your Excellency, you have not had any formal complaints as of yet?
No, there was no formal written complaint saying that because of this day we have lost business by this many, this much, and amount wise, in terms of number of items being sold or in terms of the value. So we have not received any complaint. But if there are the substantive proof of that happening, then I think this is subject to review again.
Yes, Your Excellency, I know you won't get or you won't find time to go through all these online informal discussions and comments posted by many individuals, frustrated individuals actually, because we are good at it. We do not formally lodge complaints. We do not formally speak to the public forums where whatever you say is already in public domain. But we are good at hiding our identity and posting comments and on views online for everybody to see, and most of them could be malicious in intent at times. So do you sometimes go through all these discussions and feel frustrated and say that, okay, I regret for having taken this decision?
I think as long as the decision is taken in public interest and not an individual interest, and not for personal benefit, I think there should be no regret on the part of the government or anyone of us, because we did not gain anything from this. In fact, we are as much inconvenienced by this as anybody else. You know, my family, my children, my my friends' children, everybody is affected. So we also suffer the inconveniences as much as others do. And I'm sure some of the complaints are genuine, and I think the committee that has been set up to look into this are doing their best to make accommodate those complaints and make changes as necessary to ensure that their inconveniences are looked into, and yes, to the extent possible to help them resolve that, to make it work for them. So we are working very hard in trying to find solutions. There were complaints about vehicles not allowing to go straight to a destination, the long distance travel and so on. So we have worked with the concerned Dzongkhag authorities, with our Royal Bhutan police authorities, to ensure that those traveling long distances are allowed to go without hindrance and so on. Similarly, even those mothers with breastfeeding children, we are looking at solutions of either allowing them to work from home or to take a half day's leave and so on. So we are trying to find solutions for every genuine problem that we come across.
Your Excellency, this could be the final question for tonight's program. Lots of comments, lots of views being posted, yet the bottom line is some sort of assurance should be there that the public transportation system will be improved as soon as possible, and also the footpaths that we have should have been properly taken care. So this kind of assurance is, if you could give it to all our people who are watching this program.
Yes, I think that is one of the key concerns. Yes, we, if we didn't have a pedestrian day, many people would not have noticed that we don't have actually proper footpaths, or we don't have proper public transport systems. Now that people are participating in this pedestrian day, they realize that these are not there. So our Tromde, the Thimphu City Corporation, and the concerned agencies like the Bhutan Post, all are working very hard to accelerate the process of developing proper public transport system. We are increasing the number of buses. We are also now working on a master plan for making proper footpaths and so on. So these things, I think, the positive side of the business, perhaps that would bring more direct benefit, would be more investment into facilities like this for the general public.
Yes. Your Excellency, thank you so much for your time. Popular or unpopular decision has been made, and it's only for the general public to cooperate for the decision that was made. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you very much, and I hope that everyone will cooperate, because as I said, this is not intended to cause any harm or inconvenience to anyone in particular, and we all have to take collective responsibility to make this a success. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Your Excellency. On this note, we would like to end our program. Thank you so much for watching Dawai Kudroen. Until next Wednesday, where we bring in another edition of Dawai Kudroen, it's time to say goodnight and Tashdalila. Thank you.